welcome back to my channel. My name is Helen and all that good stuff, boring, normal stuff. I'm doing Gymshark 66 challenge. This will be my maybe 7th vlog, I think. I spent the weekend in Amsterdam and it's Wednesday and I'm still dying. So I didn't film yesterday because I didn't do anything yesterday. I just sort of got back to like eating normally again. I didn't train. Today I'm doing both, like eating normally, which for me is just counting calories on my fitness pal. 1800 calories is what I'm currently aiming for. Then today I'm training as well. But because it was like 4 nights of not really sleeping and drinking, and I'm not well. Ash was just chatting to Ash and he just said, just rest until your next session. So I'm gonna finish uploading a video, but I do just feel like I wanna go home and lie in bed. Like, I feel ill. I'm sure I'm not ill. I'm sure I am just like slightly run down from the weekend. Oh my god, this is just not ideal. Like, we're halfway through, no, we're over halfway through, and having like 4 days off, not ideal. Like, the whole thing is supposed to do something every day for 66 days. Technically, I haven't done it for 4 days. So, yeah, it's fine. We're back. We're fine. It's all fine. It's fine. You know, I've had my porridge. I've already had like a litre and a half of water. I just thought the more water I have, the better I'll feel. And then before my next session, I might eat again. I think I've got some chicken and stuff. Oh, I just feel bad. Feel bad, you know? So every Wednesday, I train with Marty, who is one of my clients, and we do some kind of horrible cardio circuit. And today was no different. I just wanted to introduce it because if it's in the diary, it means I get it done. And I, having watched that intro and my enthusiasm, I'm pretty proud that I still trained and I didn't bail. I go anywhere, anywhere with you, 'cause you fill my mind, or you fill my mind. We could build a dream, start up something new, let the old be dead, let the shadows leave my head. When the world is on your shoulders and you feel like falling over, just come a little closer. I'll be there for you, I'll be there for you, 'cause when we are together, I know you feel the tension. Just let me in your head so I can be there for you, there for you. Food of the day. I actually really fancy something sweet, but we don't have anything, so I'm actually having cheese.
I've weighed it out. This finishes my calories for lunch, I just ate carbs, so I am so underneath on protein. But I'm not over on calories, which has been my main focus. But we need to eat more protein. Ash is under as well. So see you tomorrow, where I'll be awake.
So it's Thursday. It's actually 11 a.m. I've already been to work and home and had a nap. Had a headache since last night, which is not ideal. I'm gonna blame lack of sleep slash now actually weird sleep, because I've been napping every single day since Amsterdam. But I just feel like I have more sleep in me. That makes sense. My alarm goes off in the morning and I am, anyway, so I'm like new levels of tired, genuine sleep deprivation tired instead of moaning tired. But the aim today is to do what I did yesterday, which is stick to my calories and get a workout in, even if I feel crap. So, bloody cold today. And also yesterday I drank 4 litres of water. I'm on my second already today, so hopefully that will help. I'm just eating the rest of the meal that I started and was eating cold earlier. So I've just got this left. And then I'm gonna go and get a monster and then I'm gonna train because I'm so tired. But I wanna train and I wanna smash it. So I said my goals for the day were to hit my calories and to train. So taking them off the list, getting it done. I'm gonna do legs, but obviously mostly glutes, not really legs. And it's gonna be good, hopefully. Hello and welcome to the workout voiceover of the day. This is my glute workout and oh my god, I actually died. I started with some glute activation and as you can see, I am going really, really slow. So now I'm actually going to speed it up. The first movement, your leg is going back and out as a rotation from the hip and you've got 10 alternating. Then you've got 10 alternating to the side, so there's no rotation, but you're just trying to use your glutes to pull the leg out and push against the band. Then 10 really slow squats, again focusing on your glutes and pushing your knees into the band. And then 10 leg swings on either side, and you do all of it twice. From there, you're moving on to back squats. I did a set with just the bar that I didn't film. I just did 10 to 12 reps just to feel it out and get my glutes fired whilst I did it. And then I did a set of 15 with 40 kilos. I'm going for a sumo stance, so really pushing my knees wide and I'm pulling my hips as far back as possible. So there's a lot of a backward motion rather than sort of vertical motion. So hips back, knees out, I'm trying to think about stretching through the glutes. Then there are 3 working sets, so 3 sets of sort of 8 to 12, which I know is a really big rep range. I managed this, is 60 kilos, I managed it for 10 and I thought I could go a little bit heavier. So then my last 2 sets I decided to do 65 kilos, I still managed 10, I don't think I could have pushed out an 11th. But yeah, go for a rep range, and if you're not sort of dying at the end, then you need to put your weight up. Next, you've got rest pause sets, and I've seen these. Hannah Oberg has done them, and Whitney Simmons, and I'm sure loads of other people. But I actually hadn't done them before, and I really liked them. So I've got a relative amount of weight on the bar, not my heaviest, and I'm doing 10 reps. Then I literally pop it down and I count to 15 out loud, well, under my breath, but anyway. And then push out another 5, and that last 5 is killer. So choose a weight that you can do 10 with, where 9 and 10 are tough, but it's not like your maximal for 10 reps. And then when you get to do the next lot of 5, it's just, the pain is kind of ridiculous. I'm kind of glad you can't see my face actually. But you do 4 sets of this. So 4 sets of 10, 15 seconds rest, 5. And then I rested for about a minute and 20 seconds, minute and 30 seconds in between sets. I tried not to rest too much, but it blinking hurts. Next, we have sumo deadlifts. And I was aiming for 1.5 reps as one rep. However, I found it very tough. I think I chose a weight that was too heavy for the half rep. So the full rep felt really good, but then the half, I didn't feel in my glutes. I felt my core and my lower back was taking a lot of the work. So when you deadlift or sumo deadlift, especially, you should feel like your glutes are working and then your upper back is stabilizing your shoulders. So if you feel it's in your lower back, you need to go lighter with the weight or fix your form. So the first thing that I did was try and fix my form. I did 2 sets of sort of 10 reps. So one full one and one half one being 2 reps, not being one. After the second set, when it still didn't feel good, I just went and did just 10 sumo. So each rep being full, so no half. I think this would have felt better if I'd done the half as like a lowering phase rather than lifting phase. Anyway, so it's 3 sets of 10. Go for some of those reps being like a pause if you want to, and if it feels good, go lighter. Or just go for 3 sets of 10 sumos, because honestly, after the other 2 big compound movements, this is killer. And I think by this point I was in shock. Those 3 big movements, and then trying to get here, I was pretty much shaking all over, couldn't really catch my breath, in a lot of pain in the glute, and yeah, just I was on the struggle bus. So this is a single leg deadlift, but with your back leg supported, so you're almost similar-ish position to a Bulgarian split squat, but just a narrow stance. You're going to put a very limited weight on your back leg and just focus on the supporting leg. So I would sometimes put my hand on my bum, or I push my hips back literally with my hand. There's 12 on each side, and you're going to do 3 sets in total. Again, I'm a big fan of going really slow and making sure you're feeling in the right place. And if it doesn't feel right, if you're not feeling in your glutes, if your core is really tired, then you're best off dropping your weight and making sure that you actually feel this in your glutes, because there's no point sort of pushing through lower back pain, because then you're using the wrong part of your body. So it's definitely what I'd say when you're doing a big session that's really tough. Drop the weights, because it's so intense, it will still be difficult. You want to feel it in the right place. And if you're anything like me, if you try this, you will feel your glutes for days afterwards. And I don't get glute DOMS that often, and I was really happy because I had DOMS so badly after this workout. Final exercise to finish off the session is a cable hip abduction, or a side leg raise. So all the other exercises have been very much hip extension focused, so I wanted to make sure that we're hitting the glutes from more angles. So that is why this isn't a kickback, it's a side kick instead. Did 12 really slow, really painful ones, you guessed it, for 3 sets. And I had like 2 kilos, and it hurts so much. Go slow, make sure you're feeling it in your glutes. If you feel it somewhere else, go even lighter. These are really hard, just body weight, if you keep your hips still. So yeah, choose a weight that is appropriate for how you're feeling at this point in the session. But 3 sets of 12 slow ones on each side, and then you're done. Yay! I just realized that I lied. Oh my god, so you're not done. Obviously, if you want to just work your glutes, you don't need to do any kind of cardio finisher. But I did 5 sled pushes on our new treadmills that we've got at work. So instead of an actual sled, which we don't have, they just put weight through the belt. I didn't go crazy heavy. I think I did like 30 kilos for 40 meters. So it was quite long rather than quite heavy. And I did 5 sets, and each of them had a 40 second rest in between. So that was my like cardio sprinty kind of finisher at the end. Oh my god, that was so hard. I died. I've showered and I still feel like I'm sweating. I'm so red because I've got no makeup with me. Oh well, I'm eating my 3rd meal of the day.
broccoli, a teeny bit of sweet potato, and then a chicken thigh. I've got no knife with me, so I don't really know how to eat it. I am done! Yay! I just bought some chicken and turkey sausages from Tesco's so that we can food prep tonight. And I have to like wash up before I do any cooking, and I hate that. But it's really late. It's 8:45. I've just got home. I should be home at like 9-ish. I'm basically gonna have like eggs, chicken, and veg. Like, oh, I'm thinking like Mexican eggs. Yeah, like avocado, fajita seasoning. Oh yeah, yeah. I'm really tired. But I feel so good that I worked out though, which is amazing. But I was sweating for so long after my workout. Because that's attractive. But yeah. I mixed protein cheese and regular cheese together. And then I reckon gave us about 50 grams each, maybe. We've both got 2 eggs, half a teeny a tiny avocado. And then I used a pack of chicken, which was 320 grams. And then a whole pack of mushrooms. And then a whole yellow pepper and half a red pepper. So all good ingredients and hopefully filling. Because I'm starving, and I think Ash is starving too. Did you want toast on the side? I'm not having any.
I might do actually. I'll put it in.
I can put it in for you. Hi, it's Friday and it's raining and I'm tired. This is breakfast. It's carnage. Training of the day has been like 3.5 hours of dance. And I have died slightly. We filmed it so many times we couldn't really get it, but we found it on Instagram, or Carrie did. So I'll link who the choreographer was, because it isn't ours. But we loved it, which is why we wanted to try it. And also, who doesn't have an ex? They're like, bye, Felicia. So, yay! Made a good choice. They've gone for chicken thighs, corn on the cob, and char-grilled veg, and the water. And it's, you get 4 chicken thighs, which is amazing. So I should be full, and hopefully not too jealous of Ash, who is probably going to get something amazing. Cold, very, very cold. See you in my next one, and until then, stay happy and healthy. Bye!